This time I'll be installing the tiles around the bathtub.
After I put the tile back around, I caulked along the bottom all the way around the tub with silicone to seal that gap. I also caulked down along the sides right beside the apron or the skirt, and that will stop any water that could possibly get in around the tub. The tiles that I'm going to be using are 3x6. I guess people call them subway tiles. It's a good traditional look that I want to stay with in this house. I'll be doing a running bond, which is like a brick bond. You'll see they half overlap the joints. To put the tiles on the wall, I'm going to use thin set mortar. This is a white thin set. It's the standard thin set. It's about $22 a bag, and I think the bag is 50 pounds. This is my preference. I don't like the premix glue that you use. It's a little more convenient for sure, but it's a lot more expensive for some reason, and it's not nearly as strong as this stuff. When they give the instructions for mixing up the mortar, they talk about things like icing or cake batter.
But really, what do real men know about icing or cake batter?
I mix it up until it's still fairly tight. When you take it up on the beater, it maintains its shape. I don't want it too runny. I don't want it dripping off the beater because I don't want the tiles sliding around on the wall. I'm leaving the beater in the mix so that I can occasionally whip it up. To do the majority of the cuts on the tiles, I've got this tile cutter right here. This is a mechanical type. You know, the wheel type, a lot of people, I guess, are afraid to use that, but actually it's really easy to use, and it's the best one for glazed ceramic tile. I've also got this wet saw that I'm going to make the trickier cuts with, but I'm going to limit it to that. It's not a very good saw, and it does spray water, so I'll have to protect that wall a little bit.
Anyway, I've got a flat seam. I've used some fiber tape to reinforce that joint. And I'm just going to take a little bit of the thin set and scrape over the top of it. Now, I had a little trowel to do this with, but I can't seem to find that. So I'm using this putty knife just to get it out of the wall. Then I can spread it with the quarter inch notch trowel. Then I'm going to start laying the tiles. I'm using these little plastic spacers, which are really convenient because they're all the same size and I don't have to make them. I'm just laying those on the tub deck because I know the tub deck is absolutely level and straight. The normal procedure is to chalk a line across and then bring your tiles up to the line, but I've already checked this tub and it looks great, so I'll stick my first tile right in the corner, push it in with moderate pressure, get it right tight into the corner. The next one goes in the same way, except I'm going to use another one of the spacers between the tiles. And it's just a matter of putting the rest of the tiles across to get the first course done, and I can build up from there. Okay, now when it gets to the last tile on the wall, this is one of the ones that was cut in half, and it should be a good fit, and it looks like it is. If it's not, if it doesn't fit, if it's too wide, you can always cheat the spaces across to get it in, or you can cut a little bit more off, which is probably not a good idea. Or if it's not wide enough, you can cheat the spaces open a bit more. Right here I see I got no thin set right down there in the corner, so I'm just gonna scrape some up above, put on the corner. Also, you wanna put the cut edge in the corner. So I'm working on the next row, and the way I like to get it in place is I like to set it down on the tile below, up tight against the one previous and just push it lightly in place. Then I can slide it up and get my spacers underneath and then slide it over to get my spacer in there. And what that does is it keeps the joint clean. It doesn't fill it with mortar, and then I can push it lightly in place.
Okay, well, it's coming along pretty well. One thing though is I am running out of spacers, so I've taken the time to cut the ones I had in half. They still fit in there, no problem. Some people think these are plus shape so that they'll fit right in the corner of the tile and you'll leave them in there. That's simply not the case. They're plus shaped so you can slip them in from any direction, vertical like that too, to increase the gap. One thing is certain with tiles, laying them anywhere, you're gonna have to cheat. So putting something in the corner like that and locking the tiles in position is not gonna be something that's gonna work for you. Also, it's gonna limit how much grout you can get in there. It's not a good idea.
I've come up about four courses, and what I wanna do now is put this soap dish in, and that goes right in the corner here. Now there's two ways to install this. One way is to do like I'm going to do right here, and that's to put it in right in with the tiles. That's probably the best way. The other way is just to take it and kind of glue it right in the corner after the tiles are done. You see that quite a lot, but that's not actually the proper way to do it. Now I back buttered this edge because there's no thin set on this part of the wall. This side is dry still. I'm just going to stick it right in the corner, right on top of the tiles that are already there. Now I've cut a stick to prop up this side right here, because I'm not going to get these tiles done yet. Now just like the tiles, I'm going to put the spacers in underneath to get a good grout joint. I'm going to do the same thing under my prop, since that is cut to the same height as these tiles. All right, I've got my first tub saw cut to make, and that's that tile that fits around the soap dish. It's this cut right here. Now, this is virtually impossible to do any other way, mainly because of how thin this is. You could, a very skilled tile setter could nibble this away with a pair of nippers, but I'm not that guy. So I'm gonna use this machine right here. I'm gonna make this straight cut first, then this cut. Chances are if it's going to break, it's going to break on this piece, and no sense making this one first. Do that one. Okay, there's my piece mostly cut. I'm just going to snap that off inside the corner there, and then I'm going to get in here with the blade very carefully and clean that bit out. Now, if I did a good job cutting it, it should fit right in there. And it looks pretty good.
Yeah, that's the back wall done. I still have quite a bit of mortar left, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started on the end wall and get as much of that done as I can.
Okay, as you can see, I've got a lot of this end wall done, and I've come to a difficult area. It's this hole for the handheld shower, and it's pretty much right in the middle of the tile. Now, this is a cut that, I don't know, I'm not gonna try to do with the saw. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to mark the center of where the hole needs to be on the tiles that are beside it and below it, and I'm just going to put the tile in, get it in place properly, and leave it there. And what I'll do is I'll drill out the hole after the tile is set.
Well, that's that wall done as well. I just need to do this end wall here, and since I still have some mortar, I think I'm going to try to see how much I can get done. In the meantime, I'm not sure I have enough tiles, so I might run out of those. Well, I had enough tile to do the end wall, and I got that done. I still have some mortar left, so I went and I got the bullnose tile to do around the border, and I'll get started on that now. For these tiles, I'm not going to try to line them up with joints or anything like that because they won't. These are 6 inches long, which is the same length as the tile, but oddly enough, it doesn't match the coursing because I've got a space between. The coursing this way would be 6 1/8. I just cut them off at a 45 degree angle for this corner here. Check to make sure that they fit good and they look good. Then I'm going to do what's known as back buttering. Now, back buttering is just where you take some of the mortar and then you put it on the back of the tile and then you put that in place. It helps a bit when your mortar is thickened up. To hold the tile up in place, I'm just going to put a couple of finish nails at the bottom. Just tacked in. And now it's done. Now it's around 2 o'clock now and it's all finished. I used less than 200 tiles, 3x6. I think it was around, I had around 5 left. Used 32 of the border tiles. The killer with those is they sell them by the piece, they don't sell them by the box. So, and they were $1.50 each, so that was a bit expensive. That was actually the cost of a box of tiles right there. So, that's a bit of a ripoff, I think. But it was the look that I was going for here, so I couldn't use anything else. Normally, I'd use a termination strip, a metal strip that you put on the wall first, and then the tiles go up into that. But that's a little bit more modern look than I wanted here. So if I get time tomorrow, I can get this all grouted. That shouldn't take long. It is one of the parts that I hate the most though. I don't mind laying tiles so much as I really don't like grouting. I hate it.